Hi, I'm some tech guy and thanks for joining me. In this video, we're going to change the fans on an MSI gaming trio card. This one's a 3070, but you can follow this for any of the range. Replacement fans can be found on eBay and similar sites, and at the end of this video, I will give you some important tips on buying them. To do this, you don't need to touch any of the screws on the backplate or remove the heatsink, and you don't need to touch the warranty sticker if you have one. We will need to disconnect the fans from the PCB header sockets, and in order to do this, we need to use a magnetic screwdriver to remove the fan shroud with these six screws which you can see here. We will then need to remove the three retaining screws from each of the fans. So let's get started. First, unscrew the six screws on the fan shroud. You can see here that the fan retainer screws are black and have flat heads. These screws do look very similar to the screws that secure the fan shroud. However, if we remove one of the shroud screws, you can see it has a rounded head. So let's keep these screws separate. Now, let's remove the fan retainer screws. The next step is to remove the fan shroud. This should come off easily, so if it doesn't, as you see here, check you have removed all the screws. It looks like I missed one in the middle. Now, as you lift the shroud up, you will see that the tabs for the shroud screws sit below the fan blades, so you will need to carefully rotate the fans to allow the tabs to pass between the blades. The Torx 4 fans on the Trio cards have gaps only between every other blade. As you lift it up, you will notice the shroud is still connected to the PCB with two cables at the top. These power the RGB, and though they can be disconnected, there's no need, and we can just fold up the shroud and move it out of the way. Next, you will need to gently prise open the aluminium retainers so you can remove the cables. Then, we remove the header plugs from their sockets. Gently wiggle the cables left and right and they should come out. The MSI cards don't have tabs you need to push to release the plugs. Now, let's remove the fans. For the right-hand fan, it may be easier to pass the plug through the retainer, as you can see here. If we look at the back of the fans, we can see the model number. This is your starting point for getting the replacements, and I will give you some other tips on this once we're putting the card back together. Let's install the new fans. Route the cables back into the aluminium clasps. These hold the cables in the correct place so that they don't get in the way of the fan shroud. I recommend you line the fans up to the screw holes on the heatsink now, so that the cables sit in the right place to allow you to easily screw down the fans once the shroud is back in place. Then you push the header plugs back in with a gentle but firm push. Put the shroud back in place, again moving the tabs back between the blades of the fans. Having the fans not screwed down yet helps make this easier, as you can move the fans around to accommodate the shroud. Make sure the fan cables are in their guides and not poking out, as this will stop the shroud sitting flush on the heatsink. Once the shroud is sitting correctly, realign the fans ready to screw them in. Let's screw the fans in now. It may help to loosely fit one screw and align the other holes before tightening all three down on each fan. Now, let's screw the shroud down, and then I can give you those tips on buying your fans. If the screws don't take easily, just check the holes on the tabs are aligned to the heatsink fixings, just like you see here. And once they're aligned, they should screw in easily. Once you have one in, screw down the screw in the opposite corner, and you should then be set to screw in the rest from there. And now onto those tips. Tip 1. Use the model number to find your fans on sites like eBay. I showed you the model number for my unit in the video, and I'll include it in the comments below. Tip 2. Check the fan dimensions. The model number should be adequate, but in practice, aftermarket fans could differ from yours. The Supreme fans, for example, are 95mm in diameter, but the Trio are only 90mm, even though they look very similar. Also, you should check the screw hole dimensions and the depth of the fans. Again, I will put the measurements for mine in the comments below. Sellers usually also list these dimensions. Tip 3. Check the cable lengths on the fans. I have seen matching model numbers where the cable to the fan header was too short. Sellers may not post this information, and you may need to check with them before you buy. And thank you for watching. If this was useful, I would greatly appreciate a like and a subscribe to help YouTube share this with others. And you can find other of my videos here. And of course, see you in the next.